Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Tuesdays with Puddinhead. I'm joined by Henry Ketchup this time around. I am playing an Araxian Crown Warlock for the first time in a very, very long time. And Henry is playing the Force Master. I'm a little nervous about this matchup. This is the very first time I've played this book. And that dodginess is gonna do some damage to me, I think. We'll see how it goes. I'm kind of hoping that I can win this with curses. I'll be honest. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Alright. First round. I've prepared 2 mana crystals just because. That seems to be all the rage these days. Not gonna quick cast. I wonder what kind of Force Master this is. If it's a DOT Force Master, I could be in some serious trouble. Because I only run 2 spells right now. I plan to be the one doing the cursing. I think I am gonna move closer just in case he Mind's Eyes, so that I can get closer than that. Henry is kind of famous for, in the last EDMW, he beat Ash's Necromancer with a Thought Spore Mind's Eye build here, and it looks very similar to that. Yep, there we go. So we are just going to have to get in close. Alright, we're in deploy from round 2, and like I said before, Mind's Eye and Thought Spore. This is probably going to be another Mind's Eye and another Thought Spore, and the Thought Spore is going to attack me through the Mind's Eye. That is my guess. I'm going to put Tempered Folds on and see if I can reduce the acid coming my way, because I'm pretty sure that's going to be an acid ball on there. Could be telekinetic bolt. Yeah, here we go. We gotta get in close. I think I might double move this turn. If he doesn't hold me still, that's gonna be how we have to do this, I think. Alright, we are gonna... Let's get into the middle of the arena here. So that I can't be force pushed into the wall. Mind's Eye, yep, double Mind's Eye. Makes sense. And he chooses not to do anything with those Thought Spores. I think next turn is going to be double Fireball for me. We'll see. End of the round. Alright, we are back in deploy, and I have prepared Lesser Teleport and Fireball because I kind of expect him to force hold me at the beginning of the round. I would have liked to double Fireball and kill both spores this turn, but not going to happen right now, I don't think. Alright, I'm going to pass first quick and we'll see if he uses his. Yep, there's the force hold. Ooh, Tanglevine. Nice. So I can't even Lesser Teleport out of that. Alright. Well, that's irritating. Okay. I'm gonna pass. Let's see what he does. Probably an acid ball. Yep. It's 2 damage. Good. We only got the corrode. We did not get the damage. It's fine. I'm gonna pass again. And this is where I probably should, instead of putting the bear strength on, I should have run to over here. Now he could always force pull me away and stuff, but blur, okay, nice. All right, I am just gonna use my Warlock's Punch on the Tanglevine. I'll reveal bear strength just to get a good hit in here. Hey, we got it. We killed the Tanglevine. Nice. Alright. I fully expect another one to come next turn. I'm gonna pass there. Alright, so I'm gonna increase direction. I am gonna use the lesser teleport on myself now. And move over here so that during the quick cast I can fireball, unless of course he pulls me, but if he pulls me he's going to use up one of his mind's eyes, so that's that. End of the round. All right, so we didn't deploy. First quick cast here, another blur on this thought spore, so I'm not going to quick cast anything. He's probably going to tangle bind me again. That's a force hold, I bet. Yeah, force hold. That's fine. Alright, I'm just going to pass. I'll just put my Necropian Vampirus out at the end of the round. Fireball and Vampirus here is what I'm doing. And, I think I'll save my dispels for mind controls. Surging wave, alright. 4 damage in a daze. Alright, nice roll from that there spore. Alright, we're going to remove the daze because we're just going to do Vampirus here. And we'll see how this goes. The good news is he's not using non-living, so if I can actually get attacks off on these spores, I can heal off of them. And my final quick cast, I'm not going to do anything with it, I don't think. End of the round. Alright, we are in deploy, and I have prepared Mage Bane and Necropian Vampirus. I'm going to Mage Bane him right now, because he does not have a blur on him. And I'm going to be doing extra damage. So, like I said at the beginning, DOT is probably going to have, I'm going to have to beat this guy. And this is a mind control or mind seize. No, surging wave. Okay, that's fine. It's not like she can hit anything anyway this turn, so no big deal. All right, quick cast is over. As soon as he's done with quick cast, we'll keep going here, and I'll probably pass. Yep, I'm gonna pass. Let him do his thing. He's probably gonna acid ball the Vampirus. I wonder if that's a blur. Maybe a nullify. Maybe a force field. That would be great if it was a force field. All right, then we are gonna activate the Vampress and remove this. Do I pay the one mana? Move in here. And that turn is over. And we'll see how much damage he can do with his 3 mana. All he can do is cast Acid Ball at this point. Tentacle Sting, Bribery. Yep, Sting Tentacle. Pretty much the norm there. And we're going to do this. And cast another Vampirist. And we'll see how long he can sustain taking care of these creatures here. Tentacle Sting or Acid Ball? I would Acid Ball probably at this point. Yeah. Nice. Only one corrode, so I still have an armor left. So that's good. No final quick for me. And end of the round. Alright, we're going to deploy for the next round. I have chosen Nullify and Ghoul Rot. We'll see what he does during the first quick. I am going to quick cast and nullify on this Vampirist so that she doesn't get mind controlled. Then I'm done. I'm going to use my mage's full action to put my surging wave on the Vampirist. That makes sense. I'm just going to have to go for it this time. Alright, slam. Alright. Activate. And we're going to pay 1 mana to gain flying. And we are going to target this guy with 5 dice. So, effect die first. Make it, and then 5 dice. Nice. So we're going to heal 2 damage. And our daze is gone. And I'm done. Got 4 mana left. Even if these Vampirises die, killing these Thought Spores, is actually a huge, huge bonus for me. So, Nullify apparently was a bad idea, because he's not going to control it, he's just going to attack it. So he's still got 5 health left. He has no mana. So he's gonna roll. Oh, he got it. Oh my gosh. Alright, that's fine. Alright, and we are gonna target the Force Master with an enchantment. See if he's got a nullify on. Quick from him. Alright, then we're going to reveal Ghoul Rot. And be done. All right, we're in deploy on the next round. I have prepared Flame Bast and Firestream this turn because I want to take out those Thought Spores. And I am going to move over here. And Firestream, I think. Hold on a second. Surging Wave is kind of more important. Hold on. Yeah, no, we'll do it. It's fine. Do this. Now it's Firestream. Oof. That was a bad roll. And then we will quick cast. And Flame Blast. Oh my gosh. Well, it might burn to death. Those are some bad rollins. It happens. It's a dice game. He's gonna Surging Wave my Vampirus now, which is totally fine. And then he gets the slam. We are going to use our Vampirus and try and get through the days. And we'll kill this one, hopefully. Maybe we can get really lucky. Effect die first. Five dice. And we got five damage. Not dead yet. That's annoying. Alright. Done with my turn. Yep, here comes the acid ball. Gonna hope that this guy burns to death in the upkeep. It's pretty low chance. But, we'll see. With creature actions. Quick cast. Force field, I'm guessing. Fair strength, maybe. Alright, one damage. I can take one damage. That's fine. I wonder what those. Oh, he has no mana to reveal anything. That's why. Alright, end of the round. Alright, we are in deploy. I have prepared Dispel and Lash of Hellfire. I'm wondering if he's going to reveal something this turn. My main plan is just Lash of Hellfire, walk in, and kill a Spore, honestly. But we'll see if he's going to Force Hold or Force Crush or something. Tanglevine again. Wall of Force. Nice. Good. So I can move over and dispel if I need to, but I will probably just move two and lash. Alright. Or I could hit the Mind's Eye. I am rolling seven dice. Here's the Surging Wave again. And gets a slam. Alright. We are going to try this again. Controlled Daze. I'm going to pay our one mana. And might as well try and kill this guy. So first the dice roll. Got it. That's really lucky. And we killed the spore. We only heal two. Or one. We only heal one because it's... Oops, wrong one. We only did two damage. Can't do more than actual damage. Man, if I had rolled that the first time, I would have just one shot a spore. Alright. Done with my vampire. These vampires have been really useful. The getting the flying with one mana is really, really good. Ouch. Alright. We're gonna go in here. And I'll cast the lash. So he's either gonna have to force wall again, or yeah, you know what? He's gonna have to force wall again. Cause and I'm gonna just if that happens, I'm just gonna fire stream that stupid spore. End of the round. Alright. First quick cast. I am going to cast Agony on the Force Master just in case he decides to Force Wall and try and hit my Vampirus. So we're going to see if that sticks. No, guess not. Maybe? If he's gonna force wall? No, he's gonna... Oof. That's awesome. Well, that's a dead vampire. You know, if I had been smart, I would have put Rise Again on my vampires. But I didn't, because I'm an idiot. Alright. Dang, son. Where were those rolls last time? Alright. Now it's one-on-one with this Force Master. Desperate focus does not work. All right, we figured it out. All right, I'll take that. It's going to be his action next round. Alright, we're in deploy. I have no deploys. It's her quick cast. I've prepared Surging Wave and Spiked Buckler this turn. Quick cast Tomb Guardian. Nice. Okay. I think that I'm going to quick cast Spike Buckler. So I get a counter strike on the Force Master. And I might be able to dodge it. And he took his Mage Wing damage, so that's good. And he's figuring out what to do. So he's definitely putting Tomb Guardian on guard, which is totally fine. Wonder if he's going to Symbiotic Orb this turn. He's going to guard. Okay. He's not going to guard. Yeah, that would not be the best choice. Because then I can hit him instead of the Tomb Guardian. I wonder if that's a force field. I should probably find out. I don't want to waste a Surging Wave on a force field, though. You know what? I'm actually winning this game. Because he's just taking damage right now. So... I might as well. Hit the Tomb Guardian. I get 5 dice. He's gonna hit me back. I'll try and dodge. No, failed to dodge. That's alright. Ouch. That hurts. Alright. Shouldn't have done that, probably. Alright, first quick cast. I am not going to first quick cast because I have a plan. And we'll see if he first quick casts. Wonder if it's a reverse attack. That would be cool. Except I'm going to Surging Wave him. And that'll get rid of reverse attack. So I'm not too worried about that. Redistributed power, maybe. Be a decent choice. Alright, is he done with first quick cast? So my plan is to Surging Wave and then hit like a truck this turn. It looks like he didn't do something that would keep me from doing that, so I'm not going to need the Arcane Corruption this turn, but I will Arcane Corruption and Blood Demon next turn, I think. So here we go. Surging Wave. Got the slam. Alright, Rhino Hide. Rhino Hide's fine. Then I'm going to take my action and hit him with. Okay, what does that do? Oh, he's got Aegis 3. Okay. So manual 4 dice, because he's got Aegis 3 this turn. No burn. Sadness. Alright. I'm done with actions. No defense. That's too bad. 2 damage on the Warlock. Because I have no armor on. I really should put some armor on. Adds a card to Tomb Guardian, that's fine. He's got a daze. He makes the daze. And does the damage. Nice. Agony, man. Agony is so good. Alright. That's the end of the round. Alright, we are in deploy again. Neither of us have a deploy. Let's see if he first quick casts. He is not going to first quick cast. I don't think I will first quick cast either. He might do a remove curse. But he can only get rid of two things right now. Remove curse. Nice. What's he getting rid of? 10 mana. On Agony and Mage Bane. Alright. And where's the Agony? There it is. So he's not taking Mage Bane damage anymore, which is fine. And did he get his 2 mana? Yeah, he did. Okay. Good. And he's done. Alright. So we are going to do this. I'm going to put an Arcane Corruption on him. And then we're going to do this. Drain life and see how much we get. We got 8. Oh, that's awesome. And since he has enough mana for a Seeking Dispel, I'm gonna. Now I'm done. Oh, he's gonna call the GG. So he's gonna take, yeah. Yeah, Arcane Corruption would make it so that he is gonna take 4 damage. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, 4 damage, and that's all the life he has left. So I thought it was 3. I had forgotten he just put 4 shield on himself, actually. So Arcane Corruption for the win. I really think that it was very important for me to get as close as I did, as quickly as I did. I probably should have gotten closer faster. I do like the Tomb Guardian addition to this book. It really helps. Tomb Guardian is a great way to keep you alive one-on-one. It soaked up a couple of attacks, which was very nice. I would also put a Symbiotic Orb in, honestly. Now, I also may have tried to save up a little bit more mana so that I could get rid of more of this enchant stuff. Now, I have a ton of curses in here. A ton. So I don't know if it would have helped. But yeah, I don't know. I could definitely have Theft of Life on him and been healing myself. And I had my own regrowth and stuff, and I had Vampirism, but I needed to wait until the Tomb Guardian was dead so I could keep attacking the Force Master. I had another Surging Wave that I could knock him down with and then hit him with my big melee attack. But I honestly didn't need to. I was waiting for a Galvatar to show up, but he just never had the mana. And I think that is the trouble with running double Thoughtspore, is you just don't have the mana to run all those spells all at once. I think you want to put like a Stalagmite or a Rock on one of them, Acid Ball or Surging Wave. Yeah, and he just wasn't ready fast enough. I closed a lot more quickly after I saw the eyes come out. When I saw the eye come out, I was definitely interested in closing as quickly as possible so he could not just pepper me from afar and set up. And I really think that's how you have to deal with a mind's eye book like this. So yeah, hopefully everybody learned something from it, and thanks for watching Tuesdays with Puddinhead.